Hi, in this lecture, I will talk about the female external genital regions. These are commonly known as vulva or pudendum. It consisting of all externally visible part in female reproductive system, that is mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, clitoris, and the vestibule containing the openings of various duct. Here it is the mons pubis. Sometime it referred as mons veneris. It is a mount of subcutaneous adipose pad which lies anterior to the pubic bone and is covered with the pubic hair, as you can see over here, with the various sebaceous or sweat gland. The lower part of mons pubis is divided by a fissure which separate it into a labia majora. Labia majora is present in the lateral aspect, as you can see in this color, which is formed by a skin, subcutaneous tissues with adipose fat, where they join medially or form posterior commissure in front of the anus, and it is covered with the hair follicles, which is similar to mons pubis, with the having sebaceous or sweat gland. This structure is similar to the scrotum in the male reproductive system, as it covers the reproductive organs. Internal to labia majora is the labia minora. These are the two small fold of skin without any fat pad or the hair follicles. Anteriorly, it encloses the clitoris and unite to each other, as you can see in this color, and form clitoral hood, or you can say prepuce. At the lower end, it fuses together medially and form a fold of skin which is known as forget. Then there is a clitoris, a small erectile tissue which consists of various nerve endings, and their parts are glands. This one, it is the exposed region. Then posterior to that is, which is covered by the prepuce, is called body, and the lateral extended regions are called crura. This structure is similar to the male penis, as it arouses sexual excitement in female. Last one is the vestibule, that is a triangular space bounded anteriorly by the clitoris, posteriorly by the forget, and on the either side by the labia minora, and it has various openings, you can see in this figure. Anteriorly, there is a urethral orifice or urethral opening. It is in midline and through which urine is passed. Posterior to that is, here it is, the vaginal opening, and it is partially closed by a fold of mucosal membrane which is termed as hymen and is receptacle for male penis, or the passageway for the birth of baby as well as the menstrual flow. On the either side of urethral orifice, there are the openings of skin gland or the paraurethral duct, which directly open into the vestibule and it lubricates the urethral opening. On the either side of the vaginal opening, there are openings of two duct of Bartholin's gland, which is also known as greater vestibular gland. These glands lie at the posterior end of the vestibular bulb and it secrete mucus to lubricate the vulva. And the last is vestibular bulb, as you can see over here. These are the bilateral elongated mass of erectile tissue which lies beneath the mucosal membrane of the vestibule, and it causes narrowing of the vagina during sexual intercourse. Hopefully, you get an idea about external genital regions. Thank you.